participate in this part of the service? Why did they hand me a velvet lined bushel basket? Is this some kind of hint to put a lot in or what? I suppose I ought to contribute something. The church has its bills to pay. These are comfortable seats. I must admit that. Come to think of it, they've got a lot of nice things around here. Like Pastor Scott's new office. I'm sure that cost a pretty penny. Next thing you know, they'll be adding a McDonald's. A cash station. This ain't cheap stuff. I bet when you become a member, they really start putting the pressure on you to give all the time. This place must be rolling in the dough. What good is my measly couple of bucks going to do anyway? And besides, how will I know where it's going? Now, if I spend my money, I know where it's going. I'm sure you understand, God, if I take a pass this morning. From the looks of this place, compared to my living room, I need the money a whole lot more than they do.
Yes, the offering. What a wonderful time of the service. There's something about being able to participate in what's going on here. To be part of funding this great work of God. A very, very, very large part. I amaze myself with my generosity. And I just know that I could be such an example to others. Of course, how can I be an example if they don't know what I'm doing? I certainly wouldn't want to tell anyone what I give. Well, that would be too obvious. Of course, if I don't fold my check, then the people next to me can see it. Or maybe I should put it on the rim. Then the whole road would be able to see it. Oh, but it might fall off. Hey, but that would be perfect. Because then the people in the row in front who pick it up could see it too. And then they'd have to pass it around and have it catch up to the plate. And as that's going up around, maybe more people would see it and be inspired. And then the person on the end of the row would have to stand up and call to the usher, Sir, there's a very large check from a Mr. Cheney A. Stillwell, 10724, Rice Court, that I'm sure the church couldn't do without this week. And then Scott would see what's going on and have me come up. And I'll bet he'd make me honorary chairman of the board of directors right there. What a joy to be a humble tool.
Sunday morning, just building my little business. What a prison. But here I am today, and now in a tangible way, I have a chance to show you how much I appreciate your presence in my life. This is for you, Lord. Oh, no.